Generation was begun in about 2004, roughly. I was working down in London in an old fire engine factory, the Merriweather factory. This is my studio. I just returned from New Orleans and I was making that work. I basically came up with some designs, which were then reviewed by a kind of internal panel. Before I made Generation, there's some very small scale heads there, which are made out of wood and clay and plaster. That's kind of formed the basis for the whole larger work. So it was only when the design was fully agreed that then the larger scale work was commissioned, and that took about a year working for my studio in London at that time. So yeah, my thanks go to One North East for commissioning the work originally. Interested in the sort of utopian ideals that grew up around all this geometry, and it was like the distillation of 3,000 years of mathematics and these simple triangulated three-dimensional curves. I'm also interested in the way that we're constantly reinventing the way we describe ourselves through technology. Start out making objects, making sculpture in three dimensions. First thing you're trying to do is make them stand up and defy gravity and actually have a life in the real world as a kind of an animate. And the first sculptures I made probably used wire and wax, and but over the years I've started to make work for sites outside and you know, sites in the real world. So they've got to kind of be pretty robust. So for that reason, I start to use metals, kind of more heavyweight, serious sculpture materials, which are kind of like historically have been used a lot in sculpture. But hopefully I mix that with a kind of contemporary view on what it is to look at ourselves as human animals. There's not one given meaningful, but the following two heads, the stainless steel one and the iron one, resonate with different eras of human endeavour, if you like. This area, you know, the Tyneside area, is very much an industrial, or was an industrial place, built on shipbuilding, coal coming out of the ground, melting steel, and so that kind of history of it being a place where things were made out of big lumps of rusty metal is something I was very conscious of. And then the stainless steel head is bit more sophisticated, and so the, you know, that resonates with the digital age. Be invited back to the place you studied. It's a bit like going back to school, you know, you've kind of been away for 10 years. It's one of those things, isn't it? If your parents like your art, then are you doing it right? You know, you wonder, don't you? So it's a funny thing to be brought back from the place where you trained, but you know, I take it as a compliment, I suppose, that you know they wanted these pieces for their campus. So it's kind of like accreditation, but then you also as an artist, that's kind of strange.